गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू बेटा. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टॉपिक ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोलिटिक सेल एंड इलेक्ट्रोलिसिस. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द डेफिनेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोलिटिक सेल. इलेक्ट्रोलिटिक सेल इज अ डिवाइस विच कन्वर्ट्स इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी इनटू केमिकल एनर्जी. नंबर टू, व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रोलिसिस. इलेक्ट्रोलिसिस इट इज़ अ प्रोसेस ऑफ डीकम्पोजिशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोलाइट. डीकम्पोजिशन मीन्स ब्रेक डाउन. प्रोसेस ऑफ डीकम्पोजिशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोलाइट by passage of electricity through it is aqueous or molten states. Then we come with some examples of electrolysis of various compounds, various electrolytes. So under the heading of product of electrolytes, number one, we will start with the electrolysis of molten sodium chloride. Molten means pigla hoya sodium chloride, liquid state chahiye apan. Electrolytes are liquid ionic compounds. So what is the apparatus? A container filled with the electrolyte solution molten NaCl, fitted with the two electrodes connected to the terminals of battery, anode and cathode. There are two types of ions in the solution, sodium ions and chloride ions. So when current is passed through the solution, following reactions happen at anode and cathode. Important in these, all these are anode cathode reaction and overall reaction that you have to learn. So anode reaction in this case is that Cl negative ion will go to positive terminal anode and loses their extra charge in the form of electron and get converted into chlorine gas. Therefore anode se kehdi gas liberate hogi? Chlorine gas. Cathode reaction negative terminal te ki hona? Reduction. So sodium ion, positive ion will go to negative terminal, gain electron and change into sodium metal. Therefore sodium metal will be liberated at cathode. So the overall reaction is that when molten NaCl is undergo electrolysis, so we get two type of products, that is sodium metal at cathode and chlorine gas is liberated at anode. Then comes electrolysis of aqueous NaCl. So aqueous means NaCl dissolved in water. So when NaCl dissolved in water, it contains two type of ion, Na ion in aqueous state and Cl ion in aqueous state. Together with these two ions, water also contains two types of ions, that is H positive ion and OH negative ions. So in this solution there are two type of positive ion and two type of negative ions. So when current is passed through solution, here following reaction happens at anode. What will happen? The two types of ion will go at anode, chloride and OH ion. But out of these two, chloride ions will have higher oxidation potential, that is tendency to lose electron. So at cathode, anode, what will happen? Chloride ion will get oxidized, they will lose electron and change into chlorine gas. Similarly at cathode also, there are two type of ions, H positive and Na positive. Out of these two, H positive ions have higher reduction potential. So H positive ions have higher reduction potential, that is tendency to gain electron than sodium ions. So here H positive ion will gain electron and change into hydrogen gas. So after this, chloride ion will go in the form of chlorine, H positive ion will go into H positive hydrogen gas, and finally in the solution we are left with Na and OH ion. So therefore the overall reaction of this process is that NaCl plus water passing electricity to it, so we will get hydrogen gas at cathode, chlorine gas at anode, and at the end we are left with the aqueous solution of sodium hydroxide in the electrolytic cell. Then comes electrolysis of molten lead bromide. At anode, bromide ion will lose two electron and change into bromine gas. Cathode, lead ion will gain two electrons and change into lead metal. So the overall reaction is that molten lead bromide passing electricity to it, so we will get lead metal at cathode and bromine gas at anode. Then comes electrolysis of water. So since water, pure water is a poor conductor of electricity, pure water so current pass nahi karta. So few drops of acid like sulfuric acid are added to water to make it a good conductor of electricity. This is the first important information. Then water contains two type of ions, H positive and OH negative ions. So when electricity is passed, H positive ion will go to negative terminal cathode and OH will go to anode. So when electricity is passed through the water, following reaction happens. At anode, positive terminal, OH ion will go to anode, loses electron, that is charge on it, and change into neutral OH species. And this neutral OH species are not stable, so four such OH species will rearrange to form two water molecules and liberate oxygen gas together with this. So this is how oxygen gas is liberated at anode in case of electrolysis of water. Then comes cathode reaction in water. Cathode is the negative terminal. So H positive ion in the water will go to cathode and gain electron, get reduced and change into hydrogen gas. Therefore, hydrogen gas will be liberated at cathode in the water. So the overall reaction of electrolysis of water becomes water when electricity is passed through it. So at cathode, hydrogen gas is liberated like in this reaction, and at anode, oxygen gas is liberated like in previous reaction. Finally, last one is electrolysis of concentrated sulfuric acid H2SO. When concentrated sulfuric acid following reaction happens, it contains H positive ions and sulfate ions. So at cathode, what will happen? Negative terminal, H positive ion will go to cathode, gain electron, get reduced into hydrogen gas. So hydrogen gas is liberated at cathode. And anode reaction is different and to be learned. At anode, what will happen? Sulfate ion, two sulfate ion will lose two electron and get change into S2O8, two negative ions. These are called peroxo disulfate ions. That means major reaction in this case is anode reaction, where sulfate ions are converted into peroxo disulfate ion. So therefore, after electrolysis, we will get H2SO8, that is peroxo disulfuric acid, as a product in place of sulfuric acid solution. That's all, beta. Thank you, Tom.